So I finally got to play some Code Vein, a game that I've really been looking forward to. Very recently, there was a network test and I was lucky enough to get a code for it. And since it's a game I'm pretty hyped for, I thought I might as well do a quick hands-on impressions video on it. And also to give those of you who haven't got a chance to play it an idea of what it's like. So yeah, we'll just get right into it. Straight away, you get to create your own character. You can choose a male or female. And I'll straight up say the customization options in this game are great. There's so many options to choose from. There's a ton of preset characters, hairstyles, eyes, face paint, accessories, a handful of outfits, an insane color palette. You get the idea. There's a bunch of options to make your very own edgy looking anime vampire, or like me, make every character look like they're from Tokyo Ghoul. I mean, they give you the option, so why not? Now, this is a Souls-like game in terms of its structure and gameplay, but it's a bit different in a few areas. For example, when it comes to leveling up in the likes of Dark Souls or Bloodborne, you can choose what you want to level up, whether it be vitality, stamina, or strength. Whereas in Code Vein, you don't get that. There's just a level up option that raises basically everything, which kind of goes to show that this isn't just your typical Souls game. As well as that, something that isn't really in other Souls games is having a partner. There were times in the likes of Neo where you were joined by other characters, but in this game it's a lot more prominent. From what I've seen, the whole partner thing seems pretty mixed. Some people don't really like it, whereas others are all for it. For me, I don't really have a problem with it. Each character has different perks, like Lewis has the ability as being able to revive you when you die, which you know is pretty handy. Just imagine you're fighting a boss who has the tiniest bit of health left and you die. If you didn't have him with you, you just die and possibly rage. Whereas if you have him with you, there'd be a higher chance of beating them. If you beat the first part of the network test, you were given the option to do a high level dungeon, which I kind of forgot to record gameplay for. But anyway, there was three partners to choose from, and you could also choose to have no partner. Now in the first mission, you couldn't choose no partner with Lewis, and I think that's because he ends up being part of the story, and also since it was kind of the tutorial section. I'm not 100% sure, but I do think after the tutorial section, the option should be in the game. And as well as having a partner, there's also online where you can have other people join your game and vice versa. Now, like I said earlier, Code Vein is similar to Soul games in terms of its structure. There's a hub area where you can interact with other characters, buy weapons and items. You can even edit certain parts of your character's appearance in case you want to change anything, which I think is a neat feature. Now, in this game, there are things called muscles, which are the equivalent to bonfires in Dark Souls. That's where you level up, travel to different areas. It has storage where you can obviously store things like weapons, and just like Souls games, each time you rest at these, they will reset all the enemies in the area. If you've played Souls games before, you should be able to pick it up easy enough, but there are some new things that you have to learn and get used to, such as blood codes and gifts. Basically, blood codes are kind of different builds. A blood code you get in the tutorial section is fighter, which raises abilities based on strength and dexterity. There's a bunch of blood echoes and gifts, so you can mess about with them and see what works for you. So whilst we're talking about this, we might as well get into the gameplay of it. This game kind of plays like a standard Souls game. There's a light and heavy attacks, you can evade, there's a stamina bar, there's even visceral attacks, which are just called backstabs in this, and they basically work the same way as they do in Dark Souls. You get behind an enemy, press the button, and you'll do a bunch of damage and look really cool whilst doing it. The combat in general feels pretty smooth to me. I don't really recall having any issues with it. I feel like it's responsive, and I'd say that pretty much every Souls game has its own learning curves in terms of how it plays, how fast enemies attack, their AoEs, timing your parries, getting used to the weapons. Like I said, if you've played Souls games before, you should be able to pick it up easy enough. There's just a handful of gameplay features to get used to, like your gifts and deciding what blood code you want to use. Also, something worth mentioning is that this is a story game, just like Neo and Sekiro Shadows Die Twice, and from what I played, it's fine. Honestly, I'm just happy we're getting more vampire games, because I feel like we really haven't got any on current gen besides Vampire and the Blood and Wine DLC for The Witcher 3. So here's to hoping we get more vampire games in the future. The last thing I'll probably talk about is the visuals. I actually really like how this game looks. I mean, we've seen a destroyed and post-apocalyptic Earth dozens of times, but I really don't mind it in this. I generally like how the world looks from what I've seen. The same can also be said for the enemy design. From what I've played, there's a bunch of really cool looking enemies, from the basic grunts to stronger enemies to bosses. As of writing this video, I was looking online for pictures of enemies, and I seen that there are actually some new screenshots, and it shows some new locations and bosses. The new area kind of looks like Anor Londo from Dark Souls, and the big dude kind of looks like Vicar Amelia from Bloodborne, but they're pretty cool nonetheless. Anyway, I've been hyped for this game ever since it was released, and after playing it, I think it will be a day one buy. I mean, this is kind of my ideal game. It's got anime vampires and Souls gameplay, which I'm all about. And if any of you have gotten the chance to play Code Vein, let me know what you think of it in the comments, I would love to know. And if any of you have any questions, I'll happily answer them as soon as I can. And as always, thank you guys so much for taking the time to watch this video, I really do appreciate it, and I'll see you in the next one.